afternoon, friends. Hope after excellent music and wonderful lunch, somebody says that lavish lunch, then it is turn about water. So the slide is Be Smart, Save Lives. How many of them you are agree this spelling mistake? Can I see hands? Okay, almost 60%. It's in my life, most of the people think like that only. Okay, I'm mistaken. Okay, whatever I'm talking now, I'm mistaken. And end of my presentation, I'll explain you whether I'm correct or you correct, who is correct. Okay. Let us talk about today's subject is indulging diversity. Can somebody tell about what is the unique of India? What is uniqueness of India? Pardon? Diversity. Then? Agriculture. Okay. What is unique about India? Little bit louder. What is unique about India? Diversity. Okay. Yeah, many of them correct. Unity in diversity. Is it right?
Yes.
So, India have lot of geographical differences. We have many religions. Many weather different forecast, like it is in a coastal, like in South India is different weather, North India is different weather. We have many religions, we have many caste, many different things, but we all unite as Indians, diversity, unity in diversity. That's what the great uniqueness of about India. What we are talking about today's subject is indulging diversity. Diversity throws a lot of challenges for better tomorrow. Is it right? If we are not diverse and we are not in a position to, we don't have enough scope to grow. Are you agree with me? It will throw a lot of challenges. But why we are not growing as a developed country after independence of above 70 years, even we are very, it is in our inner DNA that we are diversified, we are united, but we are still not developing. The reason? Adoption.
Corruption.
Okay. Then? Who is the reason? What is the reason of corruption? Pardon? Politics? Okay. So who is going to elect politicians? Okay. So according to me, or according to lot of great people who talk about, like Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. Okay, so what is about diversity is not just being different or doing different, is making different things. Earlier speaker Charan and other people also told about, we always talk about people, and we don't talk about process, and we always complain about corruption, politics and all these things. We don't do or we are not intent do much about doing things in a different way. That's what SMAAT is coming into picture right now. Okay? If you see, Sanjana told after lunch, do you guys have had drink water, somebody says, okay, we had ice cream. But after ice cream, without water, it is not possible at all. But you see the statistics, 2.5 billion people, half of the developing world is lack of access adequate drinking water. Are you believing me? Little bit interactive will be make the things better, I think.
Camera bag, sleepy chudu, pakka unda.
If you see, why we are treating ourselves as a third world, na? The first world like our developing countries. Okay, developing countries, cost of their water and in the income, and third world is the difference. This is why still we are under development. The reason of this. Why this is happening? The cause, because we always complain, as we complained right now, the reason of corruption, the reason is politics, but we don't involve. So more than 50% plus projects in the country, as per the survey, is not success due to community don't own those things. This is the basic reason. We don't involve in our development. So that's the reason most of the projects are fail, lack of community involvement. Yes, we are not involving in this activity. See the statistics. 175 million working hours every day we lose just because of waterborne diseases. And collecting water. Lot of people, maybe Hyderabad, you may open tap, then you will get a water. But if you go to rural part of the country, so women and children, most of the children are dedicated just to collect water. There is no other duty for them. The water often is contaminated. What we are able to drink here, bottled water, but in a rural area or some of the places, we don't have adequate clean drinking water. The major causes is the diseases. And the problem is, arsenic is one of the reason, iron is another reason, nitrate is another reason, fluoride is another reason, and microbes. These are the reason. That's why we are unable to provide adequate clean drinking water in the country. If you see a working adult sick in a family, as most of the family members are forcibly to go for fast because they don't have a income for that particular day to have their lunch. If you see, as I told, first world is the cost of the water is almost 20%. Here, third world is almost 70% of water. Here in India, we spend 20% of our income just for a medical medication and healthcare, they will spend a lot of money. So most of the people think that, okay, clean drinking water is a luxury, but it is a basic human right. But a lot of people doesn't really take this as a basic human right, that nobody is involved into this particular activity. So what we need for this? This is the problem we know, but what is required is we require self-sustainable coordination between government and local community involvement, sustainable public-private partnership activities is the one which is going to be give the solution of this particular problem. So we have an innovative, successful operating model. Approximately in 8,000 communities, the community water centers is working on BOT, BOOT and DMBOT, self-sustainable model. It is also creating a lot of green jobs in the country. The objective of community water center, as we said, diversity. You know? So diversity is not giving one particular product to give this thing. We need to grow horizontally. As we know, for example, in front of us, there is an Apple computer. What he diverts, one particular product, he merged many other products into one particular gadget. Okay? He made to disappear the cameras because inbuilt camera. Internet, emails, no need to go for a desktop computer. Okay? Many other things he is able to, like all social network, internet hotspot, many other things he made, many of the things brought into one particular gadget. Here, if we want to have an inclusive growth in the country, basically what we require to provide basic need plus a lot of horizontal things. Like, we require empowerment, employment, education, we need to give an education as well as social service, health and disease management, and we need to protect our environment. This is the basic need. It is called horizontal, diversified, sustainable model, which the community water center is providing in the country right now. So, if we do this, whatever the developing activities, what is not happened last 60, 70 years in the country, this is going to be improve the family health. When family health will improve, there is a family productivity improves. When family productivity improves, economics of the family will be very sustainable. Then when family health will be okay, then community health. When community relates to health, entire country will be in a sustainable and healthy way. This is going to be happening. So community water center is a building healthy nation through a safe drinking water. Lot of people ask, only why safe drinking water is going to be bring country into healthy nation? The healthy water is going to be healthy nation. Why it is happening? I told you, if a healthy people is there in the country, the family economics, education, adult will be they lose the man hours, lot of things will be in a controlled way. So, our count, this is 2014, because I got a little bit late this information about this TED talk, just day before yesterday. Yesterday only I sent this presentation to Sanjay and it updated. As of now, we are working in approximately 8,000 communities and we are serving approximately 7.5 million people in the country. If you see the statistics, how the water village population, how many households, what kind of water plant we are given, before what was there, after what was there, the quality of water, like just like bottled water, and the same quality bottled water what we are drinking, we provide it 10 paisa per liter. So this is the customer testimonial. Padma and her family are enjoying the benefits of our community water center. This is one of the story. And how we are serving these communities is a digital technology. Smartphone kind of these things, smart card kind of these people can recharge their smart cards. They can use their money like recharging a mobile phone. And we can create their family health and we map their family, we understand that what is the statistics of the family, how many people in this family, what kind of health conditions, what kind of education level, what kind of employment they are doing, really looking for, is there any skill development kind of this thing, this kind of data. We can have a commanding control room as a server base, which is available in the head office. So like this, every day we know real time reading, control, centralized control room. So about SMAAT, we are the first Indian company who have introduced eco-friendly, user-friendly, non-chemical technologies and serving approximately 14,000 water treatment plants in 33 countries covering 5 continents including Pan-India. SMAAT is having 6,500 plus satisfied clients and 7.5 million people benefited with this SMAAT community water center. So where, what is our success story here? As same as a diversified, we have a triple quadruple approach. People, planet, as well profit. First we care about people. How we can give a proper health condition, sustainable solution to the people. Then we also looking into the planet. We don't want to damage the environment like whatever we take water, if we don't give back to the society, we don't do a sustainability, then again it is a problem. Then always we look into the self-sustainable business model. We don't want, and as of now we didn't have any kind of donations and sponsorships and like that. But we are doing this particular activity with triple B bottom, and we have a RM policy. We reduce, recycle, reuse, rethink, recover, redesign, repair, and also we, most of the time we refuse. Some places we don't want to work means we don't work. It is just not just because of we get any project we want to work something like that. No, if project is not sustainable, project is not going to meet our the standards or whatever our objective, we refuse the projects also. So this is our journey. It is almost 11 years. So proud to say we are the highest, world's highest recognizing company in terms of innovation. Many innovations, even in Middle East, in Germany, even in USA. Lot of products there we compete. One of these, what I can say, show you here, this is the Quality Crown International. I got this in the year 2009 in Buckingham Palace, London. I was covered page with a simple technology, simple modification in technology. We won this International Quality Crown Award. Recently, this month only, I think last month, not this month. So, I have received an award as a water hero of the India. So, because it is not just providing a sustainable solution, we are also increasing the ground levels. Recently, you may know, 22nd March, World Water Day, in Telangana, we did Jala Jatra in association with Government of Telangana. People should know, a lot of people doesn't know what is the lake and what is the importance of the lake, what lake, if we are going to keep the lake in a healthy condition, how it is going to be. We know only Hussain Sagar Lake or some other lakes. Okay, we are very near to Gandipet Lake, we did one project here also. Like this, we created a water pledge online. We reached within 3 years 130 countries, and Earth Day Network is our major partner globally. That's what our big achievement. Way forward, if we see, India have 6 lakh villages. Out of 6 lakh villages, as of today, there is 1,31,480 quality affected villages. They are not really blessed as of today, a potable drinking water. It's a basic human right. But till today, this big quantity of people doesn't have less of safe drinking water. That is what our model is, easy replicable model, self-sustainable model. Simply we can adopt anywhere, and it is user friendly, and it is very robust model. That's what the way forward which we are planning. And still we are only targeting about next, by 2020 we want to cover only 25,000 communities. The rest other communities, we are looking some other innovation will come forward where this all the people are going to get clean drinking water by my guru, Dr. ABJ Abdul Kalam's vision 2020. By year 2020, at least India will have sustainable water solution for each and every individual in the country. You can see the statistics here. To you it may be not much, but to them it could be everything if we provide clean water. Thank you so much.